Clubs are back. Let's go.
Don't forget, keep those heads on.
We are at the Leonardo Hotel, very, very close to the airport. So we're not in Aberdeen City Centre. We're nice and close to the airport, which is actually very close to the con, which is the P&J Live. So let's do the hotel review. So we've got a twin bed. We literally just dumped our things here. And we're going to go out for a quick burger and bite to eat and have a couple of beers. So yeah, this hotel, not too bad actually. So we've got our pops on here. We've got our paint pens. My suitcase just here. Bathroom's actually quite lovely. Look at this. So we've got a nice shower. Got towels in there, a bit extra towels here, actually some shelving for towels, pretty nice actually. And so yeah, that is the hotel review, guys. Anyway guys, let's get on with the car, let's get a bite to eat down us, and let's get ready for Comic Con Aberdeen.
Good morning YouTube, we've got some friendly faces.
Oi oi.
And we've got another friendly face.
Hello.
You can tell it's early.
We're just about to go get coffee and head to the con, so got a couple of dining passes as well today, so it should be a really good day. Let's get down to P&J Live.
So a quick little refill.
Those are putting
up, yeah. Excited, lads?
Yeah, it's freezing though.
Oh, I said it's going to be grey in Aberdeen, and it is fucking grey, isn't it?
Yep.
Shades on.
Looking forward to this though.
Let's do some queuing. Let's go.
We are here at P&J Live, Comic Con Aberdeen, and look, we're actually on a bit of a panel here. Probably the best, one of the best seating panels I've actually been to. Joe does a little pan of the whole con, so it's all in one room today. There is a little seating area outside, but you, as you can see, you've got props, you've got wrestling ring. The celebs are going to be over here, so all sign up there. The photo shoots, but yeah, photo booths are just in this corner as well. But no, looks really impressive. I think we're all in good spirits right now, so yeah, should be a really good day. So welcome to Comic Con Aberdeen. Let's get on with the rest of the day.
The Death Eaters come down to the Burrows, the Weasley house, and they like set it on fire, and we have to like jump through the fire outside the house, and then Harry and Ginny are like running through the reeds, and it's like water, and we had to like run incredibly fast, and they had a camera on like a quad bike that was following us like super, super fast. And I remember that being quite high stress and high energy. And it was in the middle of the night that we filmed that. I really loved all those high energy scenes.
So. Right guys, so the photos are all taking place just to the right of me. We've got all the celebrity signings and the two photo booths. So you've got photo booth A and photo booth B. So we queued up for Karen Gillan. We've got diamond passes today, so managed to get the Karen Gillan photo done. Karen was lovely. I was actually a little bit starstruck. Don't get starstruck with many guests, but when I saw Karen, Karen's quite tall as well. It took me a bit by surprise, but really great experience meeting Karen. Photo, not a great photo of me. I look terrified. So I was a bit starstruck from the photo. So there you go. But yeah, I'll put it on camera properly for you guys. I'm gonna show you Joe's photos now as well. So Joe got his photo with Karen Gillan, and he's also got his photo with Bernard Hill. So Joe's got his photo with Bernard Hill and then Karen Gillan as well. Thoughts on Karen Gillan, so when you met her briefly?
Very, very nice. She was very nice to the people in front of me. There was a few people with disabilities in front, and young kids, and she made like a massive effort. It was a little girl, she couldn't be older than 5 or 6, with a Nebula t-shirt. Oh. She went, Nebula t-shirt, that's the coolest thing I've ever seen. And the kid was like, so yeah, really cool. You don't often get that at these photo shoots. You just shunned in and out. So,
She actually spoke to every guest that come in, everyone that come in the photo booth, she actually said hello. And it's more like the actual talking. It wasn't like just being polite, she actually just speaks to you. So yeah, really great experience meeting Karen. Gonna meet her again later on to get our pop signed. But yeah, and Bernard Hill,
quite underwhelming. He looked extremely old, to be honest. He did pose and stuff, and he did say hello and talk. Had to sit on a chair because I don't think he can stand for a long time.
Yeah,
to sit on a chair next to him. Yeah,
I was sitting down. Ooh,
But no, it doesn't look like it because you can't see the chair. It looks like, yeah, so both sat down.
Oh, poor.
But yeah, he was nice enough. Yeah, not much to say about it really. Can't really say underwhelming because of his age. So yeah.
Anyway, we've got loads more panels to do today. We've done the Bonnie Wright panel. There's Walking Dead panels, Karen Gillan panel. So plan for the rest of the day, more panels, and get some pop signed finally.
I'm going to need you to do me a favor. I'm going to need you to get really rowdy and give a huge round of applause, make a lot of noise to welcome back the beautiful Karen Gillan! Keep it going, Aberdeen! Scotland's own, making her way to hello.
Oh, hi. Oh, there's so many of you. Thank you for coming to this. I hope I'm interesting.
Look at this turnout. Can we have another round of applause for Karen Gillan? Looking gorgeous as always.
Thank you.
We're so honored to have you here. How is it like to be back in Scotland?
Oh, I'm so happy. I'm home. It feels really nice. And I'm seeing so many people that I know that have come over from Inverness.
Oh, wow.
Like my neighbors here, my family is here. And it's so nice.
Yes.
They had me fight the air. They were like, right, what we want you to do is like punch the air as if like someone's there and then kick. And it must have been the funniest thing anyone's ever seen. Like this gangly frame just fighting nothing. It wasn't good. But they were like, we can work on that. So then they basically gave me like some people who are the best in the industry to train me every single day. And it was relentless. But then I got to the point where I was, all right. And then on the next film, I was a little bit better. So by the time I got onto Jumanji, I was feeling like pretty good about my physical action stuff. And I did have to learn new things. I had to learn all sorts of martial arts and nunchucks. Weird skill that I never thought I would have.
Comic Con beer review. So we have got Moretti. Fair bit of bubbles. Had quite a big head earlier. You know, you know the rules about head. But let's give this a go then. So I'm excited for this. My first pint of the day. I'm excited for this. Let's give it a go. You know what? I'm quite surprised. I think I'm going to have to go 8.8. I've let that sit for about 3-4 minutes. So I'm actually really impressed. I'm going in again.
So we've both got a Beavertown Neck Oil IPA. This is a lovely pint in a pub. And to be honest, the price difference is expensive if you were buying it on its own. It's £8.50 if you bought it on its own. But in a pub, it's about £7 anyway. So it's not that bad. It
smells very refreshing.
Yeah, very, very fruity. Want to give it a whirl?
Yeah, I'll give it a whirl.
Ta.
Oh, look, you enjoyed that.
That is
really, really nice. Yeah, I like a drink that's not too gassy. It's very crisp, very refreshing. And yeah, the head's lasted on it. So yeah, it's just been a good pint.
Out of 10, need a review?
Out of 10, I'll go 8.5.
Sure.
Yeah. 8. I agree. About 8.5. It could be higher actually. To judge it as a con pint, it's by far the best con pint I've had. He's a lover of Beaver. You heard it here first. Mm-hmm. We'll see you later.
I'm coming down here.
Kari's about to smile. That's really good.
Yay! I love it! It's so good!
Thank you so much. Good to meet you.
Yeah.
Oh, I like
the
Awesome.
Wait, you guys share a room?
Do you want to get your name?
No.
Knock it off!
Do not bring me into this! Knock it off!
I got knock it off.
What did you get on yours, Joe? Let's see it for camera. Idiot. Nice. I like that.
What a dog.
Those are cool, guys. That was really, really quick. I need to get a diamond pass next year.
So yeah, we've got another pint. My pint's all for this time. But Joe, how's the con been for you so far today?
It's been really, really good. I'm very impressed. I really like the venue. I don't think the event map does it justice, and it gave me nervousness for no reason because it doesn't show this room. We're in a room now, for example, that is a bit like a hall at the XL where. It's just full of tables for people to chill out, have a drink, have a bite to eat. And yeah, it's been brilliant. Really, really good. All the guests seem to have had a really good time. Everyone's saying they're enjoying it. Karen was in really good spirits, wasn't she? So yeah, it's been great.
Yeah, I've got my Nebula pop signed by Karen Gillan. And she took the time with it as well. We got course of the Diamond Pass as well. She only had a 20-minute slot to fit whoever she could fit in for the time, because she had to do photos. But yeah, within about 7 minutes, we got took straight to the front, got it signed, got a quote as well. So yeah, we got the Karen auto, the name of the character Nebula, and then I went for the quote from Guardians of the Galaxy 3, Knock It Off. Milky, your thoughts on the con so far? Can you take the mic?
So my thoughts on this con are it's the best con I've ever been to, and that's regardless of the guests that are here. I didn't think that the experience with Matt Smith would ever be topped, but just seeing the use of the Diamond Pass and how quick that thing gets you to do stuff. I don't have a Diamond Pass myself, but my friends have a Diamond Pass, and that allows me to also jump queues as well just by being with them, and that's one of the best things about it. The venue is top notch. I'm super glad that I've had this booked for the last couple of months, and even Joe was apprehensive about coming here at first, and just to hear him say he loves this is a tick in my book. I'm definitely coming back here next year, and I appreciate the boys spending time with me. So, yeah, I love it. Before this, we just met Bonnie Wright, and I got a pop signed for a friend. And yeah, she was a really nice person to talk to. She even gave me a little bit of Harry Potter knowledge behind the scenes, because I said to her, I said, how did so much blood come out of the cat's tail? For her to write on the wall, the enemy of the air, beware. And she said, actually, we kill chickens and we use the blood to practice writing.
It was real blood?
Yeah.
Wow.
It was chicken blood.
Wow, okay.
She said it was chicken blood that they put on the walls.
Not cat blood.
And it wasn't cat blood. So yeah, just a little thing like that you would never have known. I've seen all the Harry Potter time many, many times, and I never knew that little small fact.
What are you doing, mate?
I'm finally in the queue to meet somebody I've been trying to meet for a long time.
Yeah.
Who am I meeting? Robin Lord Taylor. He played the penguin in golf. Great guy.
And what have you got for him today?
What have I got for him? I got a pint. Half a pint. And a packet of crisps.
You got a pose ready? You should do
a pose ready.
You should do a pose with a pint.
No, I'm probably just gonna get him to put his arm on my shoulder or something. Something like that. Maybe pint. I maybe pose with a pint. It might be funny.
Yeah, do something funny. Do something funny.
Don't know what I'll do, but
I'll meet you around the other end anyway.
Yeah, no,
to see your reaction.
My reaction when I come out, yeah,
that'd be good. Yeah, alright, have fun. It. Have fun, mate.
Thanks,
we'll see you soon. Milky, how'd it go?
He spoke to me, he was really nice. I said to him, I said, do you know how long I've tried to meet you? I says, I tried to meet you in Edinburgh and I had a panic attack and had to go home. And he said, I'm so sorry you had a panic attack, at least this one's better. And I was like, yeah. And then I says to him, I says, if you could play one character in Game of Thrones, who would you be?
A question as well.
Yeah, and do you know what he said? Joffrey. He said he would play Joffrey.
I know the Joffrey.
I didn't see it, you'd play a great Joffrey. And I got the pint in there, boys.
If Joffrey had
lived. That's a great picture. That is a great photo.
Tits and wine. Oh.
Yeah, I only got a tits and wine. And look, small actors can make it in the job, so I've got hope still. Because he's not massive, is he?
Nah.
That was a really cool, I really like it. Really nice guy. Really, really nice guy.
Right, guys, so we're just by all the celebrities where they're doing all the autographs and the photo booths behind here. So it's quieting down a little bit now. I don't think there's that many guests here. If they are, but the queues are quite short. Robin Little Taylor's back already. Milky's just got his photo of Robin. So he's back doing selfies and autos. We're going to go in through the Diamond Lane again in a minute. We'll keep bigging up the Diamond Pass today. It's made the con a lot smoother today, so I can't complain about that. And yeah, I'm going to go get my Aaron from Walking Dead Funko Pop signed shortly. So that's the next step. And then we're done today with guests and celebrities and all that. So we're here, guys, in the Shire, outside Bilbo's house. And yeah, I think we've done a lot today. I mean, from what I can tell so far, there's going to be a lot of very, very good footage from all of us. Really great interactions today, myself and Ross Marquand. Joe had a good interaction with Ross Marquand as well, saying that like he was very got everyone involved, didn't he? He even tried to get Corey Payton involved.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Not knowing that I've met him previously, but yeah, he still tried to get Kyrie involved. But yeah, really good day. Now it's just going to be looking at the props and stuff like the Hobbit House. But yeah, so let's get up then, guys, and take a look around the rest of the con. We've got Milky doing some vlogging now. We've got some thrones here. Boba Fett's throne. We've seen these at previous cons before. Some stuff we have got here, which I haven't seen at cons, is a Dementor, which is quite a freaky looking Dementor. So we've got some Harry Potter stuff, so of course with Bonnie Wright, Ginny Weasley being here. We've also got Aragog, very, very nice Aragog, probably a lot bigger than that in the films. This is probably Aragog from the Chamber of Secrets, but it looks really, really cool. We've also got Deadpool and Batman. So Milky loves Deadpool, so Milky's got to get in with Deadpool. So there we go, there's me and Deadpool, bit of maybe a thumbnail that one. And then we've got Batman as well. Batman, not the best Batman there is, but yeah, loads of props. So we're going to take a look at more props. The boys right now currently creating content, so you're seeing a bit of behind the scenes here from everyone's vlog. So I think this is Joe's vlog getting created now. I've been Milky's vlog as well. Milky's got his camera out. So yeah, plenty of content going on today. The Walking Dead, one of my favorite bits of the con to film in. I love filming in the Walking Dead bit. And as I'm looking at right now, I can also see the blue raptor from the Jurassic World franchise. So got that to look at as well today. So loads of good stuff, loads of good content. The con is just like starting to calm down now. Yeah, not very busy. Also, more stuff here. Not really for me. I've not actually seen this film. Nightmare Before Christmas. You got what? Jack Skellington. Can't remember the dog's name. There we go. You've got the dog there. And this guy's name. I can't remember his name either. But it looks like pretty good cosplay. It actually looks like someone's in that. It's a pretty good cosplay there. And then another prop. This is really nice. So you got the wrapped up blue. But overall, guys, really, really good con today. Really good fun. Especially for only meeting two guests as well, so we definitely made the most of it. Meeting two guests, there's more Game of Thrones stuff over there. But yeah, I'm gonna wrap it up now and then we'll be a close. Might take a look at some stalls if there's anything good to look at. Milky's just got home, so.
Oh, Joe! This kid's in here, shame.
Right, that was a video, right? Let me do the photo now. Shut up. Right, hold still.
What's up, guys? My name's Headless Ned Stark. Don't forget, keep those heads on.
Twin Peaks review.
Twin Peaks review.
Right, guys, so that's it. I've not took much footage of stalls today. To be fair, it's been the same old stalls that you have seen in previous con. I think Karen Gillan's the last guest here still. So Karen's still here. But you know what? It's been a really, really good con. No stress. Got everything we wanted to do today. And I think we've also got above and beyond what we wanted, which is really nice. We've had really good one-to-one interactions. We've got Russ Marquand, Robin Lord Taylor, Karen Gillan, even some of the vendors and organisers. We had a nice chat with a guy who does all the Game of Thrones props. And we've had loads of inside information as well today from people, even including like some Harry Potter inside stuff we found out today, some inside stuff about Gotham. And then Karen Gillan panel. That Karen Gillan's panel was also really good. She told some inside stuff. But overall, really, really good day. So Joe, if you want to do a little pan of the con, won't take you too far, but yeah, we'll just take a look, walk down. This looks like a bit like Artist Alley. I'm not sure if it actually is, but overall it's been a really, really good con. Quieting down now. Not gonna pick up anything today, no pops or nothing. We bought a little lanyard, bought Ross Marquand selfie. I think that's about it from the additional stuff that I bought. But anyway, I'm sure you're bored of the con now and bored of me talking. Let's head off to the boozer for Slane's Castle, Aberdeen. Let's go.